Kapatanan, good morning. Praise the Lord. Are we all excited to praise the Lord? Manindog ta mga igsoon, and pwede ba natong tagakusog nga palakpak atong buhi nga Dios as we welcome His presence in this place. Hallelujah! We bless your name, Jesus. Praise God. Let us read the Word of God in Psalms 95 verses 1 to 3. Tayo na't lumapit kay Yahweh na Diyos, siya ay awitan ang batong kublihan. Atin niyang handugan, masayang awitan. Tayo na't lumapit sa kanyang presensya na may pasalamat. Siya ay purihin ng mga awiting may tuwa at galak. Sapagkat si Yahweh, siya ay dakilat makapangyarihang Diyos, ang dakilang haring higit pa sa sinuman na dinidiyos. Mga igsoon, we are here today because we want to praise and worship and glorify our God. Amen! Mao na ang rason nga nung naata diri karon. Amen ba? No? Tungod kay mao na ato ang rason nga naata dirin karon, then let us give our best worship to our living God. Hallelujah! Let us give Him our songs of praises and our worship as we celebrate His goodness in our life. Woo! Now let's clap our hands unto the Lord.
Kay gandang pagmasdan tayo'y nag-aawitan. Pumapasok sa tahanan niyang may kagalakan. At doon ay nagpupuri, walang hanggang kasiyahan. Sa Diyos na napubuhay magpakailan pa man. O kay ganda, o kay gandang pagmasdan tayo'y nag-aawitan. Umapasok sa tahanan niyang may kagalakan. At doon ay nagpupuri, walang hanggang kasiyahan. Sa Diyos na nabubuhay magpakailan pa man. One more time, o kay ganda,
o kay gandang pagmasdan
tayo'y nag-aawitan. Amen! Pumapasok sa tahanan ng ating Panginoon with a joyful heart. At doon ay nagpupuri, walang hanggang kasiyahan. Sa Diyos na nabubuhay magpakailan pa man. One more time, o kay ganda, o kay gandang pagmasdan tayo'y nag-aawitan. Pumapasok sa tahanan niyang may kagalakan. At doon ay nagpupuri, walang hanggang kasiyahan. Sa Diyos na nabubuhay magpakailan pa man. At doon ay nagpupuri, walang hanggang kasiyahan. Sa Diyos na nabubuhay magpakailan pa man. At doon ay nagpupuri, at doon ay nagpupuri, walang hanggang kasiyahan. Sa Diyos na nabubuhay magpakailan pa man. O kay saya at kay ganda na tayong lahat sama-sama at purihin. Wala nang iba kundi ang Diyos na nilikha.
Kay saya at kay ganda, tayong lahat ay sama-sama. Umaawit, nagpupuri, sumasayaw at kumakanta. O kay saya at kay ganda, tayong lahat ay sama-sama. Umaawit, nagpupuri, sumasamba.
Ipalapak!
Ipalapak ang iyong kamay.
Puri
Lord, we just want to give you thanks. We just want, Lord God, to magnify your name, to lift your name, O God. Hallelujah, Lord God. Lahat ng papuri at pagsamba ay para sa iyo lamang, O Diyos. Oh, hallelujah, Jesus. Ikay napakabuti, Panginoon, sa lahat ng oras, sa lahat ng bagay, sa lahat ng pagkakataon. Hindi mo kami iniwan. The life that we have right now, Lord God, this all comes from you, Lord. Kaya today, O God, here we are, Lord, standing in the midst of your presence with one heart, Lord God. As a church, Lord, we just want to glorify your name. We just want, Lord, to exalt your name, to lift your name, O God. O God, hallelujah, Lord Jesus. Come on, church, let us remind ourselves of the goodness of our God. Just like sa gingon ni King David, oh, kalagdaiga ang Diyos. Daiga ang Diyos, ug ayaw kalimti ang tanang butang ayahang gipakita sa imuhang kinabuhi. Maybe you're in pain right now, maybe you have a problem right now, or maybe you're in good condition karon. Let us just set aside everything. And let us focus ourselves, let us focus our mind, our heart in worshiping the God who gave us His life para maangko nato ang mga butang anaa nato karon. Oh Jesus, we just want to bless your name, oh God. We want to rest in your presence, Lord, as we worship you, O God. Because we believe, Lord, in our worship, miracles will happen. In our worship, strongholds will break, O God. In our worship, Lord God, restoration will happen. In our worship, Lord, breakthroughs will happen. In our worship, Lord God, we will be victorious, Lord Jesus. Healing will flow. Healing will happen, Lord God, as we lift your name, O God. Jesus. Kay buti mo, Panginoon, daki. Kay buti mo, Panginoon, kay buti mo, Panginoon. Yes, remind yourself, dakila ka sa buhay ko, sa pag-ibig mo ay naligtas.
God.
kaluwalhatian ngayon at magpakailanman. Jesus, sa'yo ang karangalan, kapangyarihan ngayon at magpakailanman. Jesus, sa'yo, Jesus, sa'yo ang kapurihan, kaluwalhatian, ngayon at magpakailanman. Jesus, sa'yo ang karangalan, kapangyarihan ngayon at magpakailanman. Pupurihin ka sa awit, itataas ang aking tinig, itatanghal sa buhay ko. Kadakilaan mo'y di mapapantayan. Kadakilaan mo'y di mapapantayan. Kadakilaan mo'y di mapapantayan. Jesus.
Father God, thank you Lord for this day, O God. Salamat Ginoo sa kamuntagon, Father God. Salamat sa iyong presensya, O God. Salamat. Thank you for your love, your mercy, your faithfulness, O God. Salamat sa iyong pagkamaayos sa iyong kinabuhi, Father God. I pray, O God, sa tanan, O God, nga ikaw magagiyang ang hikanan mo, Father God. Salamat sa life sa iyong pastors, Father God, nga ikaw magagiyang ang hakanya, Father God. Salamat Lord sa iyong word, Father God, nga ikaw, Lord, maghatag ang more knowledge and wisdom, Father God, sa mga pastors, Father God. I pray, O God, nga among apply ang words sa mga self, Father God. Angayan kang dayigon, angayan kang simbahon, angayan kang alagaan, Father God, ang ayan ka sa tanan, O God. You are worthy to be praised, O God. Lord, salamat sa iyong pagkamaayo sa mong kinabuhi, Father God. All the glory belongs to you, Father God. In Jesus' name we pray, Amen.
Amen. Praise God. Pwede makapanglingkod. Kaganina ka nang nasa imo ang tapad o sa likod o atubangan, wala pa na, ing na siya. Good morning. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Let us now get ready. Atong mga kasing-kasing, huna-huna, let's focus it to the Word of God.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. A blessed morning, everyone. Maayong buntag ka na itong tanan. Welcome sa itong first service. No, duha na taka service karon tuod kay Nanate Corinti. Medyo naskam ta last Sunday, no? Abi na ito, walay Corinti, pero naaman di ay. Right? Di ko magdugay. May I request everyone to please arise as I read the word of the Lord. From the book of Romans 15, verse 13. May the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace as you trust in Him, so that you may overflow with hope by the power of the Holy Spirit. Let us pray. Father God, we thank you, Lord, for this great day. We believe, Lord, na kining adlaw o Dios dili aksidente alang kanamo nga imong gihatag. Salamat, Lord, sa gift of life. Salamat kay Lord sa opportunity nga imong gihatag kanamo o Dios dinhi nga adlaw for us to come together in praise, in worship, in thanksgiving unto your name, Lord. And I just pray, Lord, nga among kasing-kasing o Dios amo kaning ginaablihan for us to speak to us through the Holy Spirit's convictions in our lives. We believe, Lord, nga matag-usa kanamo Dios dunay makanya-kanyang kabugaton sa kinabuhi. But we thank you that in your name there is hope. In your name, there is healing. In your name, there is restorations and change of our lives. In your name, there is power and miracles, O God. So we declare that name to manifest in our lives today, in our situations, in every family. I just pray, Lord, that let your anointing be upon your servant. Para, O Diyos, mapadeliver na ako, amin sa'yo, Diyos, imong makanakan nga doon ay katuyuan o doon ay kinabuhi. And we welcome the move of the Holy Spirit in the midst of us as we declare that this ground and this place, this whole time, is protected and covered with your blood. We welcome your Spirit, Lord, and we speak much more of you as we come together in your name. This is our prayer in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Pangkapanglingkutan tanan. Alright, so let me read it again in my key. Text for this today, for this morning is in Romans 15, verse 13, that may the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace as you trust in Him, so that you may overflow with hope by the power of the Holy Spirit. I love that word, so that you may overflow with hope. Overflow with hope. Overflow by the power of the Holy Spirit. And most people today, when we talk about hope, for them is just a wishful thinking. That I hope something will happen. Kana mo'y kasagaran nga mao'y mga words from the mouth of the people about hope. But the Bible says that hope is a confident expectations. Ang paglaom mao ka ng confident sa imong self name regardless kung unsa man ang situations. Hope is a firm assurance regarding things that are unclear and unknown. No matter unsa man ka unclear or ka unknown ang unahan sa atong life or in situations, as long as we have hope in Christ Jesus, then every single person nga dunay pagsalig sa Dios nga dunay kalipay nga gihatag comfort diri kay nato. So for this last Sunday of the month of July, magpadayon ta sa tema Healing Hope, but today is about elements of hope, mga elemento sa paglaom. Doon ako gamay nga definitions about elements, it means that one of the necessary data or values in which calculation or conclusion are based. Ang meaning sa subject nga element is one of the necessary data or values on which calculations or conclusion are based. Mauda kuno na ang meaning da kuno sa element. Another meaning, one of the factor determining the outcome of a process. So when we talk about elements of hope, asa nakatukad ang imo ang paglaom. So this morning mo na to ang agian ng subject about the elements of hope. So three things nga kung yatag senyua, things to ponder. Number one is, anchor your faith in God's Word. Anchor your faith in God's Word. I believe that every believer, every Christian do namang gyute paglaom. Pero asa ba ang imong paglaom naka-base? It be always based on God's Word. So anchor your faith in God's Word. The scripture says in Isaiah 6:13, if even a tent, a remnant survive, it will be invaded against and again and burned. But as a terebinth or oak tree leaves a stump when it is cut down, so Israel's stump will be a holy seed. Now, ang word, ang meaning ng subject ng stump is a part of a plant and especially a tree remaining attached to the root after a trunk is cut. Ang meaning kuno ana ng stump nga gi-mention sa Isaiah 6:6 verse 13 is a part of a tree, especially a tree remaining attached to the root after the trunk is cut off. Or another meaning, the visceral portion of a bodily part remaining after the wrist is removed. Sa lain pa kahistorya, kung imong tan-aw ng stump gi-mention sa Isaiah, sa atong gibasa, mao na ang sa Bisaya nga tuod. No? It could be tuod sa kanang naang, tuod sa kahoy nga bayabas, or tuod sa akasya. Ang picture that described nga ang Isaiah nga naadaw kuno'y tuod nga naputol nga nagpabilin. So, as I study this word, trees can be cut off totally. We could cut all the trees, gikan sa fruits, leaves, branches, or even the trunk. Pwede ito putlo ng naang kahoy. But as long as the stump, kanang naad, as long as the stump remains in the ground, the tree will rise up again. Unang punto, leaves will begin to show up again. Sooner or later, doon na yung kaya makita ang mapansin mo, nga doon mo sa lingsing nga mga dahon. Then eventually, branch will begin to grow up again. Una man yun ang leaves nga mag-show up, and then later on, doon ay gamay kayo siyang branch. And then, roots will begin to move again. Why? As long as nga naapa ang stump, ang tuod sa ground, there is always life. There's always hope. There's always a chance. Now, ako na siyang giagian tungod kay it's really important. The nation of Israel faced a great challenge against King Nebuchadnezzar. In 2 Kings 24 verse 13, as the Lord had declared, Nebuchadnezzar removed the treasures from the temple of the Lord and from the royal palace and cut off the gold articles that Solomon, king of Israel, had made for the temple of the Lord. He carried all Jerusalem into exile, all the officers and fighting men, and all the skilled workers and artisans, a total of 10,000, only the poorest people of the land were left. So we know the story that ang nasod sa Israel experienced great trouble with King Nebuchadnezzar, the king of Babylon. And the Bible says that 70 years sila dito sa Babylon, they were exiled. And that 70 years, wala gyud sila a hint of hope. Wala sila any idea kano sa mahuman ang ilang 70 years. Only the thing that si King Nebuchadnezzar, lahat ng mga treasures and gold sa Jerusalem nga naipon na pundar ni King Solomon, dala-dala na lang niya. Treasures. Not only that, even yung mga mighty men, gidala po ni King Nebuchadnezzar as part of the exile dito sa Babylon. So in total, doon na sila 70 years nga na-excel sila aning lugara. But after 70 years in captivity, the whole nation began to rise up again. Wala na human ang ilang 70 years nila nga, wala chance. Doon na pagbangon nila, it is because, yun ang Isaiah nga, doon na pa stamp nga nakapundar sa ground. There is the chance, there's the hope, there is a glimpse of new destiny and new life for the nation of Israel. Now in life, there are things that beyond our control. Sa kinabuhi nato, dunay mga panghitabo nato nga beyond our control, beyond our mind nga ato matugkad ang mga panghitabo. But as long as we have our spiritual strength that rooted in the Word of God, we will not be easily shaken. Same thing with the nation of Israel. 70 years, wala sila idea. Kanusa sila mubangon. But we know that after 70 years, God gave them another chance of this nation to rise up again. That in life, usahin natin mga panghitabo nga as if ba nga wala na chance. As if nga wala na paglaom. But as long as nga doon natin spiritual stamp grounded in the Word of God, then there is always hope to every believer. As long as nga nakadikit ang imo ang pagtuo sa Dios, no matter unsa man ang situations, there is always hope. Why? Because we are founded in the Word of God. Kaya it's really important nga ito, mahibawaan na ito nga, tangtangon man ang mga leaves of blessings, tangtangon man ang mga branches na ito sa connection sa mga tao, tangtangon man kung unsa man pinakapundar nga imong gisaligan nimo, the trunk of life. But as long as we are rooted in the Word of God, there is always hope. And that's why in the book of Psalms, 62 verse 1, truly my soul find rest in God, my salvation comes from Him. Truly He is my rock and my salvation. He is my fortress, I will never be shaken. I will never be shaken. Why? Because the writer of this book of Psalm 62, he knew nga, nakapundar ang iyang pagsalig, ang iyang pagtungad to sa Diyos. That means yun, He is my fortress. He is my rock. He is my salvation. In the story of Daniel, in Daniel 3 verse 17, if we are thrown into a blazing furnace, the God we serve is able to deliver us from it. And He will deliver us from Your Majesty's hand. Imagine that, na kahit sa ung-ung, sa kamatayon, sa kalayong itambog ito si Daniel. Daniel never make a barter with his faith in God in exchange for his life. I want you to understand nga si Daniel, wala sa inyo, sige, hari, ako na lang i-barter akong pagtuo sa Dios in exchange for my life. Because the only thing nga makasikta ng Daniel means siya, sige, dili na lang ko aning ni ang ako ang faith na ako, I have to worship the idols ninyo, set ninyo nininga place. But nowhere in the Bible nga si Daniel nakikbarter siyang faith in exchange for his life. He said in his word, the God that we serve is able to deliver us from it. Imagine that kind of faith, imagine that kind of declarations, that the God we serve is able to deliver us from it. Siguro kung dunay mga punto nga mga half-hearted Christians, mga half-hearted dedicated Christians, siguro mga, sige, ako nang i-barter ako ang faith just to have my life in exchange for my life, in exchange for my safety. But Daniel here, he stood with faith. He said, the God we serve is able to deliver us from it. So that is how these persons believe in the power of God. Another thing is in Job 13 verse 15, though He slay me, yet I will trust in Him, but I will maintain mine always before Him. Though He slay me, yet I will trust in Him. Even so, I will defend my own ways before Him. Sa line translation nga, bisang pag unsay maagian sa kong kinabuhi, I have to maintain my faith in God, I have to maintain my character in God, I have to maintain my dedication in God, I have to maintain my relationship with God, I have to maintain whatever the situations in life nga nahitabo nga to kang Job. We know the story of Job, walang wala. gikan sa property, sa iyang pamilya niya, and even sa iyang health niya, but He said in His Word, I will defend my own ways before Him. I need to maintain. And a lot of us, usay gaming ang problema, usay maapektuhan ang pagpangalagad sa Ginoo. A lot of us, pag dunay mga pagsalusay, maapektuhan ato ang prayer life. A lot of us, usay kung dunay mga problema, maapektuhan ato ang dedication to serve God. And sometimes, mabuta sa punto nga maitista sa Dios, ahaba taman ang imong gugma sa kuwa. Ahaba taman ang imong pakigsaad sa kuwa. Si Job, nawala yung mga property. Pati yung mga anak patay, pati yung asawa, wala may support siya. But Job stood with his faith. Though he slay me, I will trust in him and I will defend my own ways before him. He maintained his character, he maintained his integrity because that is the kind of persons na solid and all out for Jesus. Jeremiah 17 verse 7, but blessed is the one who trusts in the Lord, whose confidence is in Him. Bulahan ang Diyos, yung dun ay pagsalig sa Ginoo. Now, three ways to develop our faith. Number one is, we must deeply rooted in the Word of God. Three ways to develop our faith. I always believe nga doon na tayo mga pagtuod sa Ginoo, but when you talk about develop, it means that we need to enlarge, it means we need to improve. E para bang sa isikir reality, nga doon na yuta, napalitin yung mga yuta, naiman ng titulo, doon na portion tong intindi na semua, pwede na sugdan, pero they need to develop that area, butangag mga culvert, butangan nilag mga dalandalan, so that magwapo ang view. It's the same thing with our faith in God. To develop our faith, we need to be deeply rooted in the Word of God. I know that we have all faith in God, but to enlarge, to increase, to improve it, then we need to be rooted in the Word of God. Because a person nga rooted in the Word of God is a person that cannot be silly shaken by any circumstances in life. I always believe that. Yang tao nga lalum kayo ang iyang pagtugkad sa pulong sa Dios. Sama siya sa usa ka tuod. Nga walaon man ang tanan. But one day he will begin to rise up because founded in the Word of God. Another way is to develop our faith, to improve our faith is we must be fully attentive to His conviction. It's so hard for our generations, nga usahay, ang social media doon na ay influence sa tua. Because mauna ay trending karoon, mauna ay uso karoon, mauna siya ang pinakahit karoon. Social media has its own voice to dictate us. Usahay ang social media doon na siya ay gahom to dictate our mind, to dictate our emotions, to dictate what to do in life. And most of the time, we spend time in our social media, cellphone, Facebook, YouTube, and nalimutan to listen attentively with the voice of the Holy Spirit. And that's why, in order for us to grow as a Christian, mature, with strong faith in God, first thing is deeply rooted in the Word of God. Bago ta mamahaw, nakabasa na daan ta sa ito ang Bible reading, bago ta namahaw, bago ta mag-breakfast, bago ta mag-kape, we need to read the Word of God. And we need to listen the voice of the Holy Spirit, what to do in your problem, what to do in your circumstances. Otherwise, pag dili nato di siya maipractice nato, the social media will begin to empower us and dictate us. Kaya daghay mga tao karon nga, lahat ng mga desisyon, unsa buhaton sa kinabuhi, nakabase dahil kung sila nakita sa social media. So three ways to develop our faith. The third one is we must be willing to obey His command. Willing to obey His command because Bible reading is not just anak lang nga level, it's not enough. The Bible says that kung tama lang ka sa pagbasa, walay applications personal sa imong life nimo, nothing will happen sa imong life. Kaya, how to develop our faith, how to enlarge and improve our faith, we must be deeply rooted in the Word of God, we must be fully attentive to His conviction, to the voice of the Holy Spirit, and we must be willing to obey His command. A person with a strong spiritual stamp cannot be easily shaken, cannot be easily uprooted by any challenges in life. He always relies on God's abundance of grace and His mercy. So ang tao daw kuno nga doon na kay spiritual stamp, yung tao daw kuno nga, bisag kung saon mo nang na, mubango na, padayon ng naway, founded in the Word of God. Can never forget that word in the book of Isaiah sa atong text, atong ibasa kaganiha. As long as nata spiritual stamp, ang problema may come and go, and come and go, ang problema, ang pagsulay will come and go, but our spiritual stamp is our foundations for us to survive, for us to go on and move forward in the life nga gihatag sa Dios diri kay nato. The second thing is, develop a lifestyle of worship. This is all about the elements of hope. Asa magkagikan ang atong elements of hope? Yung unang punto atong sabtan is founded in God's Word, anchored in God's Word. The second thing is our worship. Is our worship. Psalm 77 verse 1, by the rivers of Babylon, we sat and wept when we remembered Zion. When we remembered Zion, when we remembered that place. There on the poplar, we hung our harps, for there our captors asked us for songs, our tormentors demanded songs of joy. They said, sing us one of the songs of Zion. How can we sing the songs of the Lord while in a foreign land? Now, I want you to understand, maybe some of us here, nataaning Psalm 77 verse 4. Now, some Jewish people had a wonderful life in Jerusalem. Most of them. Doon na sila maayong dagang silang kinaboy while they were in Jerusalem. They have the wonderful worship as they play their harp. As they play their harp. As they play all the instruments to worship God. They have the wonderful moment of worship as they lead people to worship God. Minto si sa templo dito sa Jerusalem. They have a wonderful experience in worship, in praise, in giving honor to their God. Using their skills, their talent, their voices to worship God, especially the harp. They begin praising God with a wonderful moment of worship and celebration of God's goodness. But now, circumstances had changed them as they were taken to Babylon as captives. They no longer worship as they are supposed to do. Nawala na ilang worship. Their way of worship were affected because of their circumstances. And scripture na ganyan that they hung up in a corner all their musical instruments, especially the harp. Now notice this one. There on the poplars, we hung our harps. There in a poplar, there in a corner of that place, we hung our harps. In other words, they stopped doing things to worship God because of the problem. When a life of worship is affected, it's an opportunity for the enemy to deceive you. Kung ang worship lifestyle sa usa ka believer, sa usa ka born again, maapektuhan, ma-damage, it is now the opportunity for the devil to deceive you, to deceive us. Why? He will begin to instruct us, to whisper us, to discourage us. Kung mawala ng atong pagsimba sa Dios, pagdaig siyang pangalan, magiging oportunidad din sa kaaway na i-discourage ta. Magiging oportunidad din sa kaaway to whisper, to lose our first love for God. Magiging opportunity na sa kaaway nga to tempt us to quit and to stop of what we're supposed to do as a believer. Kung maligsan na ang imong worship lifestyle, then the enemy will try to whisper us, to discourage us, to tell us nga there's wala na'y paglaom, to tell us nga, wala na ka'y mong gugbada sa Dios, to tell us to quit in life. And the Bible says that worship is a weapon for every believer. Ang Biblia nagayong that worship is a weapon to every believer. And worship is the main role to every believer. Remember that worship should be your main priority in your life. It's our main role in our lives as a believer of Christ to worship our God. In Psalms 150 verse 6, let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Let everything that has breath. Let everything that has breath. Talking to people. Ang tanong nga doon ay ginhawa, our duty, our mineral in life is to worship God. Because the time ang worship lifestyle mo maapektuhan na ng niya, everything will just slow down. Ang tanan mga wala, ang imong kadasig, ang imong commitment, ang imong kalipay, kalinaw, pagpangalagad sa Ginoo, mawala because something is wrong. Guba na ang imong worship lifestyle at tabangan sa Ginoo. Do you know that worship in the Bible is related to a first crime in the Bible? Yung unang crime nga nahitabo sa Biblia is related to worship. Let's take a look in the book of Genesis 4:3. Now, in the course of time, Cain brought some of the fruits of the soil as an offering to the Lord. And Abel also brought an offering, fat portions from some of the firstborn of his flock. The Lord looks with favor on Abel and his offering, but on Cain and his offering, he did not look with favor. So Cain was very angry and his face was downcast. We know the story that Cain killed his own brother Abel. Gipatay ni Cain ang iyang sarili igsoon niya nga si Abel ang pangutana. Doon na ba pinagbikil sa ilaa? Wala. Doon na ba sila issue sa family nga conflict? Wala. It is related to worship. When Abel gave his best portions to worship God, that kind of offering, nagiging siloso na itong si Abel. Why? It is because the Lord did not look in favor to Cain, but He gives favor to Abel. Both of them, they worship God, but somehow, along that kind of worship, mas gipaboran sa Dios ang kang Abel. Why? It's the best worship. And the story shows that Cain killed Abel. Why? Because of that incident nga wala matagai og pabor sa Dios si Cain. And the first crime in the Bible is relative to worship. It's really how important it is. It based in the Bible. Wala sila nagpatayan nito because of the kind of issue nga doon na sila bingkel-bingkel na daan or favoritism sa ginikanan nila nga si Adan o si Eve. No. Unsa may sala ni Abel nga nag-worship sa Ginoo sa tininoray lang. And so nakita ni Cain nga naman ang i-accept sa Dios ang kang Abel raman niyang iabay. Wala. And then, the enemy try to use this guy, Cain, kill your brother. And so, nahitabo din niya. And this guy, this first crime in the Bible is related to worship. And so, the enemy is trying to find ways to destroy our worship lifestyle. The enemy knew that worship pleases the Lord and it brings a lot of benefits. Ang pag-worship sa Diyos is pleasing before Him and it brings a lot of benefits. For example, in 2 Chronicles 20 verse 1, after this, the Moabites and Amorites with some of the Midianites came to wage war against Jehoshaphat. Three tribes, the Moabites, Ammonites, Munites came to wage war against Jehoshaphat, the king of Judah, si Jehoshaphat. Nag-join force itong three tribes, ang Moabites, Amorites, and Munites. They join forces and they attack Jehoshaphat, the king of Judah. And that kind of battle, in the scripture, that vast of army ang nakita ni Jehoshaphat attacking towards them. And King Jehoshaphat, instead of preparing himself with all his military men and having a clever idea how to defeat them, Nowhere in the Bible nga si Jehoshaphat nangandam siya nga makigira sa battle against these three tribes nga matak siya. He never consult sa mga general, oh, pila ba ato mga armas, kila ba ato mga military men? What to do? Unsay tactic to attack this people that join together. And sometimes, pag doon natin mga problema, iksanusahay, we begin to realize, ah, siguro, baka siguro, mag-solve sa itong problema ni siguro, ang Palawan, mamirinda ta, or mangutang ta. Or maybe ang problema sa ninyo, siguro is another thing, tinawanon nga idea, it's good. You know, the first thing, ayaw nimo is sit aside, ang una niyong priority nimo, pag-solve sa problema nimo is ang Diyos. Before anything, making a step, decision, have to solve your problem, first thing first, God ang unang duula nato igsoon. So what happened? Jehoshaphat, nagpatawag siya og prayer and fasting the whole Judah, and seeking God. Lahira po nila siya nga king, you know, uban king. Sige, mangandam ta. It's their pride. We have the armor, we have the military men, we have the forces, we have the idea, we have the tactics, we have a clever idea how to defeat them. But instead of doing that, ang gibuhat ni King Jehoshaphat, nagpatawag siya prayer and fasting. And so in 2 Chronicles 20 verse 21, after consulting the people, Jehoshaphat appointed men to sing to the Lord to praise Him for the splendor of His holiness. And as they went out at the head of the army, as they face these people attacking them towards them, went up the head of the army saying, give thanks to the Lord for His love endures forever. As they began to sing and praise, the Lord set ambush against the men of Ammon and Moab and in Mount Seir who were invading Judah, and they were defeated. Unsay tulya gahamit ni Jehoshaphat? Simple lang, ayang worship lang. Praising God, giving honor to His God, claiming the promises of God that God is so good. So what does it mean? Napay mga problema na ito, nga vast challenges in life. Natay mga problema sa finances, problema sa pamilya, problema ta sa itong self, problema sa itong, lahat ng challenges in life. Never sit aside ang imong priority nimo to worship God. Because the moment you worship God, the moment you praise His name, the moment you pray to Him, God will intervene in your situations. Kung ang Diyos namuhat sa hopeless situation ni Jehoshaphat, the same God, yan pwede siyang mamuhat sa imong kinabuhi nimo. For with God, nothing is impossible. I always believe that. Sometimes you have to focus in our problem. Instead of focused of what God can do in our situations na ito. Kaya King Jehoshaphat, simple lang ayang gibuhat niya. But it gives a big impact, an eye-opener sa mga tao. Imagine that vast army ang gidescribe sa Bible attacking towards them. But as they begin to worship, God, the Lord, set an ambush against men. In Psalm 69 verse 30, I will praise the name of God with a song. I will magnify Him with thanksgiving. Imagine that. I will praise the name of God. It's a worship. It's praise. It's thanksgiving. It's giving honor to this God. I will praise the name of God with a song. Praises, worship. And then, I will magnify Him. I will magnify Him. So the moment you worship God, the moment we praise and honor our God, we begin to magnify Him. Unsa na magnify? We begin to see Him as great, as a big God. Para bang kunakay magnifying glass kung any tiny object, pag gamitan ng magnifying glass, it begins to wide. You begin to see as big. Sa worship nimo igsoon. Sa praise. Magnify God of who He is. He's a big God, He's a good God, He's a great God. As you magnify Him, nga dako ka nga Dios, buhi ka nga Dios, gamahan ka nga Dios, magnify Him. As you magnify Him, as you enlarge your mind, your ideal, this God is a big God who created the heavens and the earth, that He created the universe. Think about Him, that He is a great big God. As you think that in worship, as you think that God is a big God, a great God, a powerful God, then your problem will become small. Smaller and smaller. Why? Because na, ang Dios mo'y napadako sa iyong kinabuigsoon. Ang Dios mo'y napadako. There was a time nga namin sa airport sa Pagadian. Kung tanaw na yung airport sa Pagadian, medyo dako-dako pa yun siya. A little bit nga, dako na yun ang airport kasi ang runway pa niya daan, taas siya, pabalik pa, manukad pa, dako-dako. Yung pag-take-off ng plane, pagtaas ng plane, the more nagkataas ang plane, the more ang airport nagkagamay. Sa bago pa nag-take-off ang plane, ang Pagadian, dako kayo mong tanaw siya, bilhin ako ang Pagadian. Nagkataas ang plane, nagkahabog ang plane, nagkalayo ang plane, nagkagamay ang Pagadian. It's the same thing on how we magnify God. The more you see God as big God, a great God, a powerful God, the more you see your problem is too little in the eyes of your God. Kaya dili ta makayon nga di man makay sa Dios, makay sa Dios when you begin to see and magnify Him that He is a big God. He is a big God. All the chance of life is just too small. When you allow yourself that this God that we serve is a big God. But you begin to magnify your problem, manay niya, sige kag bungat, pinulungan niya mo. You know that word last Sunday, the power of your words. Then eventually, your problem will dictate your mind. Nothing is good to happen anymore. But when you magnify God, your problem will become too small and too small. So worship is giving all our attention to God. Ang worship is giving all our attention to God. Since ang worship is the main role and duty and our main priority in life, then we need to worship God at all times, giving our attention unto Him. Not in the area of blessings. Ang atong focus, dili na area sa panalangin, sa oportunidad, ningyatag sa Dios kanato, but focus unto Jesus. Not in the seasons of circumstances, but focus unto Jesus. Kaya mga tao, dili makahatag all-out worship for Jesus, it is because nag-focus sa panalangin o nag-focus sa mga panghitabo sa kinabuhi niya. But as a Christians, we need to focus unto Him. Let's give our full attention to this Jesus that we worship, that we serve Him. Yes, na mga problema. Yes, doon mga panalangin. Just a little bit of portion sa imong attention ng imong i-divert imong mind dito, but the rest is all about Jesus. Then worship becomes essential part of our lives. So ang worship is magiging isang essential part sa imong life. Para bang di yun makumplito ang imong adlaw pag dili ka makakita sa imong Facebook nimo. Sa panahon karon, ang mga tao karon, it's so hard to live without looking at Facebook just a minute a day. Sa panahon karon, even mga bata, maruin, maboard ay lang day nila pag dili magka-play games sa cellphone nila. We are in these generations. We are in this time that this social media so much give the influence. And then if we are Christians, di ta careful ni ini, baka unya mawala ta sa tuang passing nato. So, worship is giving all our attention unto God. Ikaduwa is, worship involves self-sacrifice. Worship involves self-sacrifice. The scripture says in 2 Samuel 12:16, David pleaded with God for the child. He fasted and spent the night lying in sackcloth on the ground. Si David, tong buwanga saya ang pagpakasala nga to kang Bathsheba. Ang anak niya, nagdaot. To be exact, 7 days lang, nasa ilang kamot nila niya. David fasted and prayed to God, asking God for mercy, nga mabuhi lang yung anak niya. But instead of doing that, after 7 days, namatay yun ang bata. Subo si David. Broken kayo ang emotion ni David aning a time. But in 2 Samuel 12:20, something happened. Then David got up from the ground. After he had washed, put lotions, and changed his clothes, he went into the house of the Lord and worshiped. Siguro, yung David si Lord, kaning bata, Lord, bunga mo ni sa ko ang pagiging nakabuhat og sala sa imo niya ang bata, kung tang gustong i-survive siya, but patay ang bata. It ain't just a matter of 7 days. Ano nga time, so baba kain dughan ni David, pero he chose to worship God. So worship involves self-sacrifice. Worship involves sacrifice. And I love that thing that si Ryan nga, pag-practice sa worship team, oras pag-oras, it's a sacrifice of giving time to God. It's a sacrifice of giving our best unto God. So our worship involves sacrifice. Sa Domingo ba, unsa bang sakripisyo nga itong mahatag sa Dios? Siguro, kung gamay lang siguro, panuktok na ako sa inyong mga dughan ninyo. Pagsimbang alas 8, dapat before alas 8, na natadyari as a little bit of sacrifice. Kaya naibitawang matutao kining isis-is, kaya mag-claim ta sa ito ang sa ito i-claim, or anything na doon natin i-claim, usahay, gusto mong ito mauna nito, kaya dita gusto nga maulahe. Eh. Usa tadaaw ni mang sitri, ang sitri mag-open ang sitri og alas 9 na nay mga tawo to sa gawas, nagpaabot na. Kay gusto na gyud musulod kay nanay paliton kay mo duty na. Isana naman masabtan ko ninyo nga pag-abot sa simba alas 8 tong simba dapat before 8 na natadare first service. Pag di nimo na ma-manage, you have another option. 10 p.m. at 10 a.m. 10 a.m. Kung malit pag 10 a.m. then maybe this that conviction, yeah, it changed na itong lifestyle. So worship involves sacrifice, even our time. Right? Even our time. Kaya, sa tanong worship team, tanong yung mabaragdari, pag Sabado gani, tulog sa'yo, ayaw mong pagbilar-bilar. Para pagkaugma, dili mo ka po yun, para pagkaugma, untay mo sa simba sa Ginoo. So worship involves self-sacrifice. The third one is, worship is a form of celebration of who God is. Worship is a form of celebration of who God is. So, dili lamang attention ato sa Dios atong worship or involves sacrifice, but it's a celebration of who God is. Kinsa bang atong Dios? Here the scripture says, Psalms 100 verse 1, shout for joy to the Lord, all the earth. Worship the Lord with gladness. Worship the Lord with gladness. Pagsimba sa Dios nga dunay kalipay. Pag anhin din sa church nga, alas iti pagkapin, wala pa alas 8. Di na ka magbagot-bot. Lain na po sa jail. Oy, alas 8 man din. Pwede alas 8:15 na lang. With gladness. Kada bang kalipay ba nga, nalipay ka nga di ka malate, nalipay ka nga wala ka gi-force, apan nalipay ka because you want to be on time with God. Amen? You want to be on time with God because normally as we are, gusto po tayo on time nga blessings, on time nga sweldo, on time nga promotions, on time nga milagro, on time answered prayer, gusto taan na, pero usahay lagi. Dili po na ito, ma-priority ang dapat para sa Dios. So worship the Lord with gladness. Know that the Lord is God. Know that the Lord is God. Now I want you to remind yourselves when we talk about your worship. Kung maibalik nato ang Psalms 137 verse 1, ang point 1 kaganiha. Psalms 137 verse 1, ato kung naibalik to kaganiha ang point number 2 nga text. And I love that word in verse 2. There on the poplar, we hang our harps. There in the poplar, we hang our harps. Meaning to say, na sila sa Babylon as captives. And tungod sa problema, tungod sa circumstances niya na hitabo sila, ginasit aside nila ilang instrument, particularly ang harp. That's supposed to be ilang ma-plain nila, ma-worship nila ang Diyos. Because these people, wala mo sila gibawalan pag-worship. Yes, damo sa Babylon as captains, pero wala mo gibawalan sa worship. Not like dito sa Egypt. Kaking Pharaoh, bawal ang worship dito yun. But here sa Babylon, wala sila gibawalan. In fact, ang ilang kaaway pamagani, gustong maminaw sa ilang worship. But because of that problem, ang ilang instrument, especially ang harp, ilang ginasit aside nila. Ang scripture na ganyan, we hang our harps. Ilang gipadaplin ang harps because of their situations, their circumstances. What does it mean? In times of problem, in times of trials, never hang your passion to worship God. In times niya dun ay pagsulay, never allow yourself nga imong hang ang imong worship lifestyle nga to sa Dios. In times niya dun na kay pagsulay sa imong kinabuhi nimo, problema sa panarbaho, problema sa pamilya, problema sa negosyo, problema sa pag-eskwela, whatever it is. Problema sa magtiayon, whatever it is. Do not hang your prayer life before the eyes of your God. Never allow yourself na isit aside ang imong commitment sa Dios because doon na kay problema. Because doon ay challenges, never allow yourself na i-hang up nimo ang imong faith dito sa Dios because of your problem that is happening right now. Never abandon your opportunity to worship God. Don't just leave your skills in a corner. Ayaw biyay ang imo ang talento, ang imong skills, ang imong abilidad dito lang sa kanto-kanto because nakay problema. And so many of us here, pag doon ay problema, we begin to hang our harps, our commitment, our passion, our dedication, our promises. We cannot serve God because of the problem. And this is what really happened sa mga salita. 70 years in captivity. Wala sila gibawalan sa worship. Pero sila mismo ang mi-decide, silang self nila nga, di namin maka-worship because of their problem. And many Christians, they begin to hang up their harps of commitment, their harps of prayer, their harps of their commitment to God because of the problem. Never allow that thing to happen in your life. Why? Dili ang church mo ang looy, ikaw ang mga looy kung imong isit aside ang imong commitment at tubangan sa Ginoo. Dili ang imong kontra kung anaman kay conflict, mismo ikaw mismo ang dili. Why? Because mabag ka sa puntig soul niya, mamalajo ka ana, madrajo ka ana. Ang unang atake sa kaaway is your worship lifestyle. Pag apektado ang imong prayer life, apektado na imong dibuso at tabang sa Ginoo, then everything will just follow. Di na kaginahan na itong church, di na kaginahan makikita sa imong mga friends, imong churchmate nimo, di na kaginahan mabasa sa Bible. Why? Because your worship lifestyle is affected. Never allow it to happen. I don't know unsa yung hang up sa corner. Pasensya na pastor, dili na kami makasimba pastor because so and so forth. Dili ang church may looy, ikaw may looy because you sit aside ang para sa imoa ng mga imo main priority sa imo life as a worshiper to the living God. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Can we give God a clap of praise? Come on, hallelujah. I just declare nga walay mga agile people nga mohang up in a corner ang inyong passion to serve God because of your problem. Never allow any situations to influence your life. Never allow any problem to dictate your mind. Choose and speak to worship God no matter what it takes. No matter what it takes. Why? We have this so-called spiritual stamp, founded and rooted and anchored with the Word of God. Wala akong maantanan, just like ang home. Pero doon na pa'y tuod. Doon na pa'y tuod. Nga dili niyo pwedeng kaluto ng na because it is the decision of home. Nga lig-on ay ang pagtotabangan sa Diyos. The third one, the last one, be consistent in prayer. Romans 12 verse 12, let your hope keep you joyful. Be patient in your trouble and pray at all times. That subject, pray at all times, doesn't mean that every minute you're praying. Pray at all times, it doesn't mean nga wala na lang kay buhaton, di na lang kami skwila, di na lang kami narbahon na lang kay pray at all times. No, it does not mean. Pray at all times, it means persevere in it. Stay focused on it. Be devoted to it. Don't give up. Be habitual. Pray at all times. It is the opposite of occasion or random. Opposite ni sila. Kana ba, occasion lang makapag-ampo, occasion lang makabasag Biblia. And pray at all times, it means persevere, stay on it. Do not give up. Be devoted. Be habitual. In other words, Paul is calling all Christians and in Scripture to make prayer a regular, habitual, disciplined part of every believer. Mao'y ang punto ni Pablo. So, ang question, why our consistent prayer is really important? Nga naman ang consistent prayer, regular prayer is really important. Unang rason, to keep us firm even in the midst of life's trouble. To keep us firm even in the midst of life's trouble. Imagine that word kaganiya sa atong text, let your hope be kept joyful, be patient in your trouble. In other words, naata sa situation sa panahon karon nga, dili gyud malikayan ang trouble or kalisdanan sa kinabuhi. That's why we need to pray. That's why we need not to give up our prayer. In Hope 5 verse 7, yet man is born to trouble. As surely as sparks fly upward, man is born to trouble. Ingon si Hope. Ngan tao, nahimugso siya uban sa mga kalisdanan siyang kinabuhi niya. And Paul is saying in 1 Thessalonians 5:17, pray without ceasing. Pag-ampo nga walay hunong pag-ampo nga dili mo give up, pag-ampo nga dili mo quit. Kahit unsa man, continue, keep on praying. So why consistent prayer is really important? The second thing is, declare the finished work of Christ. Sa pag-ampo na ito, i-deklarar ang gibuhat ni Ginoong Kristo dito sa cross. Take heart, I have overcome the world. Take heart, I have overcome the world. And that means, ito yung punto nga, Lord, among gideclare ang imong gibuhat sa cross ug among kadaugan among gina-claim as your victory in the cross. We declare that finished work of Christ in our situations. We declare that finished work of Christ in our family, in our job, in our health, in our body, anything. Declare that finished work of Christ in your situations. The third one is, keep us rejoicing even in the midst of trouble. 2 Corinthians 6 verse 10, sorrowful yet always rejoicing, poor yet making many rich, having nothing and yet possessing everything. So Jesus is our joy. So why consistent prayer is really important in the life of a believer? Because we are in the midst of trouble. And we declare the finished work of Christ and we need to keep rejoicing even in the midst of our situations nata. Nasa pagtapos, igsong direk kong tapos sa Isaiah 6:13 sa itong text kaganiha that says, leave the stump when it is cut down. So it starts stump. will be a holy seed. The only thing that do not tie elements of hope is to have our spiritual stamp. The whole month of July is about healing hope. And one of the things nga doon natin paglaom ang atong kinabuhi, ang atong situation, is to have our spiritual stamp. Ang scripture na gayon nga, wala na ang Israel, 70 years na yung captive sila. But they begin to rise up because there is the spiritual stamp remains in the ground. And the same thing in life, that as long as we have this foundation in God's Word, our prayer, our faith in God, dili ta basta-bas ang matayog sa problema sa kinabuigsoon. As long as nga dedicated ta tubangan sa Dios, walay makapatayog da kanimo unless kung ikaw mismo mo decide matayog ka sa pangitabo og sitwasyon sa imong kinabuhi. Because that spiritual stamp sa Isaiah, sa itong ibasa kaganiha, it gives us a clear hope in our future. It gives us a clear hope in any situation sa life. For with God, nothing is too hard and nothing is impossible. Sa pagtapos sa month of July, and I want you to understand, kung doon naman tayo theme nga na mahinunduman, aning nga bulan sa July, is to look at yourself. Do you have this spiritual stuff that remain in the ground in the Word of God? Kung doon naman tayo nagsoon, did I always believe, klaro pa ang higayuna atong kagmaon? It is because founded ta sa pulong sa Dios. Amen? Manitog tayo nagsoon and let's give God the praise, let's give God the glory. As we come before the Lord, as we seek His face right now, may I request everyone to please bow down your head and close your eyes. I want you to talk to your God. Matag ulo, magaduko, matag mata, magapiyong. As we seek God personally. As we seek God personally. Dili ta eksemptin sa pagsulay sa kinabuhi na agin niya because nataan nga kinabuhi, nataan nga henerasyon. But as long as nga natay spiritual stamp in the ground, rooted in God's Word, dili ta basta-basta nga matayog. Makabarog ka igsoon. Makabarog ka. Kaya ni mo nang naa. Makasurvive ka. With the grace and the mercy of the Lord, as we bow our head and close our eyes, I want you to pray to God, God, help me to overcome my doubts. Help me, Lord, to overcome any disturbances of my mind. Help me, Lord, to stand with my faith and call the name of the Lord. Call that name, Jesus. Jesus. Let's come to worship God now in this place.
Purita Jesus, ang nais ko. Purita.
Bless your name. We bless your name. We praise your holy
name. Sa bagyo at sa problema, sa galak at sa pag-asa, ang nais ko'y purihin ka, Jesus.
Everybody, let's worship God now.
Ang nais ko'y purihin ka, Jesus. Ang nais ko'y purihin ka,
problema sa galak at sa pag-
sa bagyo at sa problema, sa galak at sa pag-asa, ang nais ko'y purihin ka, Jesus.
Sa bagyo, sa problema,
sa bagyo at sa problema,
sa galak at sa pag-asa,
ang nais ko'y purihin ka, Jesus.
Sa bagyo at sa problema,
sa bagyo at sa problema,
sa galak at sa pag-asa, ang nais ko'y purihin ka,
Jesus.
Hindi magsasawa ang puso ito, naawitan ka at mahalin. Hindi magsasawa ika'y sambahin, bawat sandali papuri ko'y ito, naawitan ka at mahalin. Hindi magsasawa, hindi magsasawa, ika'y sambahin, bawat sandali papuri ko'y hihimig. Hindi mapapagod sambahin, bawat sandali papuri ko'y hihimigin. Kami akayin at iyong dalhin hanggang
Praise the Lord. I always believe that the God is in His place right now in the midst of us. And one thing for sure, before I pray, that your problem, if it is matters to you, it matters to God. Kung bugat para sa imo igsoon ang imo ang pagsulay ng imong gagian karon, nakita na sa Dios. And God is able to fix in any situations of your life. God is able to fix and to solve in any situations that you are facing in right now. Ayaw limitahan Dios sa imong unahuna. Ayaw limitahan Dios. God is able to perform miracles in your life today. Just allow Him. But one thing for sure that I remind you, don't dare to hang up your commitment and your passion to serve God. Don't dare to sit aside your love to Jesus. No matter unsa man imong gianigso, no matter unsa man ang circumstances, choose to to bless the name of the Lord. Choose to worship Him no matter what it takes. Never hang up any commitment, any love for Jesus, even at the midst of trials. Because God's grace will sustain you. God's mercy is greater than your problem. And find ways to have your spiritual stamp rooted and founded in the promises of God. To the Lord, nagpasalamat mi kanim o Diyos aning mensahe imong gihatag kanamo. As we end, O God, the month of July with the theme, O God, healing hope. I just pronounce healing to manifest in the lives of your people. Healing for their physical body. Healing for their mind. Healing in every family's conflict, Lord. Healing in any financial struggles in the lives of your people. Healing in even spiritual life, Lord, I declare that today is a day of our miracles to receive from you. Today is a day, O God, Lord, to experience your power to work in us. We choose and we declare your word to manifest in us, O God, in the name of Jesus. Set your people free from any bandages of the life, Lord, na ilang experience, O God. And I speak shalom blessings and the favor of the Lord be upon them. Salamat Lord nya sa kagayon ng Dios nga among gidol among kaguray ug dakani mo. We want to experience you more in our lives, O God. We thank you Lord for your goodness nga among nakita o Dios ang tibok bulan, ikaw Dios nag-sustain kanamo sa bulan sa July. We're about to enter the month of August, Lord. And we believe and we pray for your blessing upon us. Salamat kay o Dios sa imong gugmang grasya nga imong gipahimutang sa imong makanakan. Continue to pour out your spirit to lead them, to guide them, and bless them with every aspect of their lives. And I declare the blood of Jesus to cover them. Salamat Lord sa pulong, magapabilin to Lord sa good gaw sa mga kasing-kasing. Salamat Lord sa imong gugbagasan sa matag-usakan kanamo. And that may the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. This is my prayer. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen and amen. Praise the Lord. God bless everyone.
Praise God. Hallelujah. Through the power of the name of God, we can do all things. Amen. Hallelujah.
Through you, I can do anything. I can do all things. 'Cause it's you gives me strength. Nothing is impossible through you. Blind eyes are open. Strongholds are broken. I am living by faith. Nothing is impossible through you. I can do anything. I can do all things. 'Cause it's you who give me strength. Nothing is impossible through you. Blind eyes are open. Strongholds are broken. I am living by faith. Nothing is impossible.
See, I'm not gonna live. I'm not gonna.
Panglingkod, let's proceed our time.